1,000 Faces is on the Legends of World Class Championship Wrestling today, along with the dangerous Abdullah the Butcher, Red River Jack, Spike Hubert, Eli the Eliminator, and a marvelous main event featuring Kevin Von Erich. Stay with us. It's coming up. Time again for great wrestling excitement from the past on the Legends of World Class Championship Wrestling. Hi, everybody. I'm Mark Durance with Bill Mercer for Bill Mercer. Speaking to you about the great card we have today, which has Steve Dodd against Killer Tim Brooks to head off the hour. Mills Mascaris, the man of 1,000 faces, then meets Al Madrill. Bruiser Brody's been in and out as Red River Jack and as Bruiser Brody, and he's going to be Red River Jack with Spike Hubert today against Abdullah the Butcher and Eli the Eliminator. Talk about a formidable team. Kevin Von Erich then meets Nord the Barbarian, the Bruiser Brody lookalike. So let's get it all rolling now and check out Eli the Eliminator. Then we'll be back for our first match. Ladies and gentlemen, this Parade of Champions special feature tag team match is one fall with a 30-minute time limit and the following very special stipulations. If the H&H International team wins, Red River Jack is unmasked. If the Red River Spike team wins, Red River Jack gets 5 minutes with Gary Hart alone following the match. Would you welcome, please, first, from Red River, New Mexico, 300 pounds, Red River Jack. Teaming with him from Indianapolis, Indiana, 225 pounds, Spike Huber. Across the ring from H&H International from the Republic of Sudan, 481 pounds, Abdullah the Butcher. Gary, Indiana, 295 pounds, Eli the Eliminator, with Rick Hazard, your referee.
Well, an interesting turn of circumstances in this tag team event. Right now, you're looking into the corner of Gary Hart, or were, Jim Holliday, Abdullah the Butcher, and Eli the Eliminator. Now those four will give you pause to walk down the street in this opposite direction. Across the way, Spike Huber and his partner, Red River Jack. As Mark Lorenz pointed out, the winners and the losers have a lot to lose and win in this bout. As Union man Spike Huber, it says on his trunks, Union mate. He and Eli the Eliminator, not too far apart. Eli from Gary, Indiana. And Spike Huber for Indianapolis, Indiana. Gary Hart right up, smooth up again and hammered down. Both of them hit the deck. Huber was trying to make a move around the Eliminator. They both collided, and Red River Jack is waiting for Spike to tag him, and he didn't. The Eliminator, ready to go, flying through the air, drops across the head of Spike Huber.
What's the difference?
Red River Jack coming in to kick Eliminator off.
It was only about 6 seconds. He stood there.
Here again, he tries that drop. Gary Hart complaining that Rick Hazard didn't do a count while Huber was on the mat with the leg across his chest. And he might have a pretty good point. It looks like Red River Jack has a cut on his forehead as we see a red spot on that white mask on his forehead. And Eliminator almost into the corner. Here comes Red River Jack around the corner now to try to pull him outside, and does. Down among microphone stands and various other things with us right here. It's getting kind of hairy. Take this microphone and get a little more room here as we're kind of caught right now. It is a little dangerous here with chairs flying, and there is Abdullah. Here comes Spike. He clears out everybody. And it looks like we've just been through a small hurricane.
bout of the afternoon. One fall with a 20-minute time limit. Bronco Lubitsch, your presiding referee. Would you welcome first, please, standing to my left and behind me from Waxahachie of Central Texas, 242 pounds, Killer Tim Brooks. And standing on my right in the white corner from Denton, 233 pounds, popular Steve Dodd.
And the referee is Bronco Lubitsch as we're ready to go with Steve Dahl and Killer Tim Brooks, who takes the flowers and throws them out. And Steve Dahl brought to the ring. Handsome young man in the tradition of the Von Erich, Steve Dahl from Denton, Texas. And he hammers right back. He looks like he's partially dressed like the RPMs, though, in that set of tights he has on. Killer Tim Brooks. Oh, what a slap. And Dahl sets up in a boxing style immediately. Killer Tim and Steve Dahl, Texas Stadium. On a warm afternoon. Summer comes early to Texas. Headlock by Killer Tim Brooks on Steve Dahl. That's Brooks. Down goes Dahl. Here comes Brooks again. Whoa, into the leg. Pretty made a collision. And Brooks has him wrapped around the body. And Dahl trying to come out. Torn down, rolled up. Trying to set him on his shoulder pin. Couldn't quite do it. Again, he's after it. And a wrestle on the world-class championship round here at Texas Stadium. Killer Tim Brooks from beautiful Waxahachie, Texas. City of the Victorian homes. And the killer, Steve Dahl, wrapped up. Trying to assess who has the greatest strength right now. The veteran with the long hair is Steve Dahl, the young man in the brightly colored blue tights. There goes Killer. Good move by Dahl. Dahl looking for a chance to help his own professional career right now with a win over this veteran. Cagey veteran, I guess is the term. Cagey old veteran. Killer Tim Brooks. Dahl in with extended on that arm and keeps the pressure on. Killer's been playing it pretty straight. You wonder when he's going to open it up in his own particular style. That's how you get a name, a nickname of Killer Brooks. It didn't become him because he was a real sweet guy in the ring as he comes off the ropes then, throwing that shoulder. Hammers with the elbow, and Steve Dahl is shaking it up right now. Killer trying to send him on his way, but Killer flying up in the air, hit that shoulder on the scaffolding. Sidemare move by Steve Dahl on the headlock. And Brooks is down for a count of one. Now it's Dahl up for a count of two and almost three as he finally forced himself over. Killer Brooks with a handful of his trunks to help him shove over into that almost pin. Steve Dahl with a headlock on Killer Tim Brooks. And Dahl, looked like he's hurt that leg and it's put into that scaffolding. And Brooks kicking into the left leg around the knee, and Dahl now shaken up. Brooks forcing that count to two and almost three. But Dahl gets that shoulder up.
Kill him!
Yeah. Oh, caught him in that bear hug now by Killer Tim Brooks. Hold him in tight. Killer squeezing and squeezing, and shot across the ears by Dahl, and Killer Brooks has to let his younger opponent free, but Steve Dahl hopping around on one leg, trying to fight his way back, and he's doing a pretty good job right now. To get back in this bout. And there goes Killer, almost into the cameraman, into the post, and back into the corner buckle as Dahl tries to take command over Killer Tim Brooks. In this bout on World Class Championship Wrestling, Steve Dahl ripped and pushed and pummeled. And Brooks working back on him again. And a thumb into the throat. Steve Dahl gasping for breath, choked now. As the Killer goes back to work again, twisting and ripping at left shoulder. Hammering down on the foot of Steve Dahl, Killer Brooks. And twisting that wrist back, putting the pressure on. And Dahl turns it around in a hurry with a nice recovery. Well, he came out of that one beautifully. Steve Dahl. Working and working. Dahl continuing to maintain pressure on that shoulder of Killer Tim Brooks. Watch out. Brooks. Slamming it on Steve Dahl. He keeps the pressure on. Biting on the ear now of Steve Dahl. And reverting to those little aside adventures that he is noted for. That pop in the back will slow up Steve Dahl. And Killer Brooks. Driving in now. Roll up though by Dahl. One, two, and nice move out by Killer Brooks. Almost got caught by his own intention. Rolling up Dahl, and Dahl now. Still maneuvering with that bad left leg, trying to work his way out. Dahl caught in the corner, trying to take Killer Brooks off of him. Here comes Dahl. Brooks with a miss. Nice drop kick by Steve Dahl. Up and in, Dahl trying to take charge again. Off the ropes, nice move. He comes in with a body slam, but he hurts that leg coming down. That left leg that has been badly battered by Killer Brooks. And again, Dahl rolls up. This time he might do it. One, two, and three, and he did. Brooks, for the second time, stepped into that move. Dahl was just about out of it. And Steve Dahl wins it. Here's Mark Lawrence to tell us about it.
8 minutes, 15 seconds. Steve Dahl with the small package wins the match.
Steve Dahl comes through with a victory over Killer Tim Brooks, though hampered by an obviously injured left leg. And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
Now with this special challenge event, one fall and a 1/2 hour, 30-minute time limit. Would you welcome, please, from Los Angeles, California, at 240 pounds, Al Madrill. His opponent here at Texas Stadium, from Mexico City, 270 pounds, the man of 1,000 faces, Mil Mascaras. Ralph Pulley, your referee.
Mil Mascaras, a legend in Mexico. Not only as a wrestler, but as a movie star, as a man who does television and commercials. He is absolutely one of the great stars of all time in our neighboring country to the south. And Al Madrill has an opportunity to find out just what a great, great wrestler he is on that one. As he takes it, bars those legs, and Madrill is in all sorts of trouble. Got the Madrill, got him surfboarding, got his legs crossed. The pressure is on, and Mascaras is surfboarding Al Madrill. Alberto Madrill in all sorts of trouble on the first opening moment of this match with Mil Máscaras. And Mil, who is an exceptionally talented professional wrestler. As he says, a man of a thousand faces, but he always wears a mask or two masks. So Al Madrill immediately has problems, monumental problems, as he faces Mil Máscaras. Move right into a hammerlock, twists that around to a wrist lock, rolls it over, gives him a drop, and Al Madrill, trying to come out of this trouble, has not been able to do anything yet to Mil Máscaras. Twisting on the wrist, pulling it up. Mil. Al Madrill yelling, "My arm," and he's trying to get over to his other arm, which he does, to the bottom rope. Alberto using his Spanish. And there's a slap of the hands of Mil Máscaras. Says, "Okay, we're here to wrestle, we're here to battle, and that they will do, amigo." And a tremendous strength. Look at the physique of Mil Máscaras. A twisting head scissors. And Alberto Madrill. Wait a second. I got all sorts of problems over here. That Mil Máscaras is like wrestling two people. Máscaras has no choke. He's got the foot across to the other side. And Al Madrill is in horrendous trouble right now. Hasn't laid a hand on Mil Máscaras yet. But now he has a chance to put his shoulders up. Look at Máscaras, twists on his head. Spin around and drop Al Madrill right on his back. What a tremendous body control by this man from Mexico. And once again, Madrill finds sanctuary in the bottom rope. And Mil Máscaras backs up. Ralph Pulley checking to see any hair pull. It would be very difficult using your feet as that scissors around his neck. Al Madrill looking around, comes up with a hammerlock, has it momentarily. Máscaras drops. Madrill with a hammerlock.
Seems... I got him now, baby!
Well, you wonder how long that's gonna last. The hammerlock is there. Máscaras. Ooh, what a thing. And Madrill says, "You stand there and we'll take care of things." And Madrill posturing like a super peacock, and he is popped and dropped by Mil Máscaras. And Máscaras opened fire now, and Madrill is groggy from this attack. Máscaras says, "Come on over, stand in the corner. You can even leave the ring. It doesn't make any difference." Al Madrill responding to the attack of Mil Máscaras. Máscaras says, with the edge, the palm of his fist, not with the knuckles. And that's probably true. A superb tactician. A superb, skillful man as he works and works with an abdominal stretch on Al Madrill. Is he going to give up? Is he going to submit? Continuing to twist Al Madrill's torso. Twist and twist and down to the shoulder stand. Madrill sliding out from under the bottom rope, almost on a pin here. A shot, another shot. Madrill has very little steam left in it now. He's hanging on, trying to throw a few. But Mascaras with a drop. And Al Madrill being absolutely pummeled and humiliated by the likes of the man from Mexico, Mil Mascaras. And Madrill, still to his credit, has not given up, has not submitted. Has an elbow into the midsection, and Madrill explodes all over Mascaras now. Madrill finding no way to combat. The star of Mexico is trying to do whatever possible. And then for the first time, drops Mascaras to the apron of the ring. A little groggy from that shot to the throat. Mascaras is coming back. Madrill knows he's got very few opportunities. And Mascaras into the corner buckle. One, two, three, four. And a shot to the side of the head, and here comes Mascaras in. Off the ropes. A flying shoulder headbutt. Another one, and Mal Madrill is down again. Mascaras putting on a big finish here. As he has Madrill on his back, Mascaras climbs to the top rope. Waits, times it, and flies in on the body slam. Two, three, and Mascaras pins Al Madrill after a tremendous display of wrestling technique. Here's Mark Lawrence.
In 10 minutes, 27 seconds, Mil Mascaras wins the match.
There he is, Mil Mascaras, the hero from Mexico. And we'll be back with more of World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
Pleasure to present Mr. Glenn Goza for this special number.
Thank you very much, Mark. There's a new star in the sky over Texas tonight. Young Mike Von Erich has gone on to be with his brothers David and little Jack. What a wonderful place heaven must be. Not just the eyes of Texas, but the eyes of the world were on you, son. We watched you from the very beginning, saw the very first fight that you won. We watched you fly like a young eagle straight toward the sun, flying free. Yeah, you marched to the beat of your own special drum, learned to fight right from the start, never learned to run. You knew there was a better place beyond the sun, where a young eagle could fly free. We miss you, son. We know you had to try your wings and go on and do your thing. But our memory of you is here in the ring, fighting for what you know to be right. This is just our way of saying we miss you, son. We think of all the things you could have done, all the fights you could have fought and won. And we love you, Mike Von Erich. God bless you. Thank you.
Time limit, 15-minute time limit. From North Dakota, would you welcome, please, at 293 pounds, former world champion, Black Bart. His manager, Percy Pringle, stands next to him. Bart's teammate from Hollywood, California, 250 pounds, Jack Victory. Across the ring from New Mexico, 300 pounds, Red River Jack. Bulverde, Texas, 245 pounds, Cowboy Scott Casey. Rick Hazard, your referee.
And on this edition of World Class Championship Wrestling, we start with a big tag team event. Red River Jack and Scott Casey, along with Jack Victory and Black Bart. And this is the one that we're going to be seeing as the match is set between these two right here. Scott Casey and Black Bart for the Drugstore Cowboy match. And a big bear hug and a shot by Victory in there as Scott Casey gets squeezed and pounded. Yeah, Black Bart came out recently and said he wanted to finish off Scott Casey like he did Scott's brother Steve. Steve suffered a broken leg. And Casey giving Black Bart a chop across the neck. Here comes a suplex for the big cowboy from the Badlands of South Dakota. Scott Casey stepping right into the right hand. So Bart challenged Scott to a drugstore cowboy match. And the loser must wear a saddle on his back, get out on all fours, and let the winner ride him, the loser, around the ring in the saddle. That'll be an interesting battle. That stems out of a Scott Casey Black Bart match at Reunion Arena last year. And Bart had to ride a donkey around the ring. There goes Victory out and over the top. Red River Jack giving the kick. That was not the impetus by Red River Jack. But Scott Casey going to help Victory right back in the ring. Oh, big Jack Victory. Oh, he comes up with a pretty nice kick. And right in is Black Bart hammered away. Black Bart made the challenge. The match is set now with Scott Casey for the drugstore cowboy match. And in comes Bart right in the big kick of Red River Jack. Probably lurking about somewhere is Gary Hart with one of his mercenaries, or his main mercenary, Mr. Jeep Swenson. There's Percival Pringle, the Star Spangled Boy. Here comes Casey, driving the diving fist into the head of Black Bart. And Bart shows his toughness. Bart hammered on Scott Casey. And we'll get a little double headbutt. And Casey clears him out. And Rick Hazard puts the warning on Scott Casey for the fist. Casey and Bart going toe-to-toe and battling it here. Just a preliminary to that cowboy match. As Casey comes flying through the air with the greatest of ease. And he got a count of two, but Bart's out of there. And a tag team event. Always have to watch the partner, but in this deal, not only watch the partner, but also watch Percival Pringle III, the manager of Black Bart and Jack Victory, and Matt Bourne. And Scott Casey getting a little trouble here now. It's Scott's birthday. Well, he'd like a birthday present to Victory right here. There it is. Happy birthday, Scott, the number one cowboy. That's what Black Bart is contesting. Casey trying to move over to Red River Jack. Bart comes across, and they've still got Scott Casey all tied up over here. The opening bout on World Class Championship Wrestling. Oh, those chops as Casey fighting with a great deal of venom of this man, Black Bart. Jack Victory coming back in. shots in the ropes. Now he's out of it, and Jack Victory comes in with a reverse chin lock, loses it, loses it again. And Casey right back in that corner again. Just cannot make it across to Red River Jack. And now he might, as he sends Victory flying, and Black Bart awaiting, but Scott is shaken. He's had a rough duty. Here comes Bart. And the tag is made, and coming in is Red River Jack to try to separate him. So Red River Jack stays on top of things right now. Up and over Jack Victory. Good measure for Black Bart. And Red River Jack is taking command. Nice move over the top. Here's another big kick for Jack Victory on top. One, two, and three, and Red River Jack is the winner. Now Black Bart is upset. He has a saddle, and Scott Casey sends him rolling. And a little preliminary to Black Bart, the saddle, and Scott Casey, the drugstore cowboy match. And that'll shape up as a great one. Percy Pringle doesn't look too happy. But we'll be right back with more excitement. Well, let's go down to Mark Lawrence first.
13 seconds, Red River Jack and Cowboy Casey win the match.
And now we'll be back with more excitement of World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
Minute time limit, as I will present first from Daytona Beach, Florida, 228 pounds, Rick Debrow. In the white corner, his opponent is from Africa, 234 pounds, Steve Simpson. Rocco Lewitsch, your official.
In Lafayette, Louisiana, that would probably be Rick Dubois, but it is Rick Dubow, and we're ready to go with Steve Simpson and Dubow. And with me, sitting in on this bout, is the chaplain of World Class Championship Wrestling, Gary Holder. And nice to see you, Gary.
Well, I'm glad to be here, Bill. I can't imagine anywhere I'd rather be on a Friday night. Boy, this is exciting tonight.
It is the shrine of Friday nights. This venerable 50-year-old sportatorium that has seen the likes of everything, and this one. This bout, Dubow and Simpson. Steve, voted the most, one of the most popular wrestlers of World Class Championship Wrestling. And Gary, we have a great event coming up. I say great event, and it's always with a bit of sadness you mention this in one way, and then another way you say, well, it is to the memory of a great young man, the fourth annual David Von Erich Memorial Parade of Champions matches coming up May 3rd at Texas Stadium.
That's right, Bill. You know, it's hard to imagine that Dave's been gone 4 years already. Fans still write all the time and ask for the little book about Dave. Nobody's forgotten him. That's certainly true. And I just can't just look forward to what's going to be happening at Texas Stadium. Want to invite all the fans to come out. It's going to be a wonderful card and an exciting time. And then especially a time to pay honor and tribute to Dave.
And, of course, a great deal of the money, as it has over the last 3 years, goes to very, very worthwhile charities. And right now, Steve Simpson running through Rick Dubow. And the young man from Africa grabbing in a headlock on the tattooed one, Rick Dubow.
This Simpson moves like a cat. Boy, he is something else.
He is, I always think of him as related to the Von Erich family. He has the same great moves and disposition.
Well, he's so athletic and so graceful, and he can be all over you in a hurry. This Dubow's finding that out right now.
As Steve Simpson working on Rick Dubow here in our bout on World Class Championship Wrestling at the Sportatorium in Dallas, Texas. And Simpson running through Dubow. Up and in, a nice move. And there's Dubow's into the ropes. And the young man is frustrated right now. speaking of the Von Erichs, too, the Von Erichs life and legend and wrestling and as a family, that Front Row Ringside video cassette is just a marvelous production, Gary.
Well, this is going to be one of the most exciting things to ever happen for a Von Erich fan, because not only do you get to know all the inside story of the Von Erichs, but it's something you can watch over and over and over again. Makes the perfect gift. I mean, what could you buy to give someone for a birthday or for any kind of special occasion better than that Von Erich video?
Well, first you buy them the VCR, and then you buy the video.
Well, I'm sorry. That's right. Get the whole deal.
Yeah, you always make a great present, won't it? Think of your a number of folks you could do that to.
Get the whole deal.
But you're right. The cassette is a marvelous, marvelous production. And Steve Sipsa with the body scissors on Rick DeBoe. Rocco Lovich is a referee in this bout on World Class Championship Wrestling.
Well, this crowd is really into this tonight. There has been such an exciting card all night long. The fans at home just don't realize it's impossible for you to understand what's going on if you're not here live. You miss so much, and especially just being a part of the crowd.
Well, the crowd is always sort of the linchpin, I think, of wrestling bouts. They're the ones who bring the enthusiasm, excitement to all that athletic ability in the ring.
You know, one thing people might think about is that there are opportunities to bring groups down here. We have a group tonight from the First Baptist Church in Dallas, the College and Career Group, directed by Toby Snowden. And when groups like that come, they can call the office and get special rates and special seating, ringside, and you're recognized by all the people and seen on TV. It's a wonderful time together.
And Sipsa trying to put a wonder on this one, too. And did he get three? Not quite. I thought he had the bout. 5 minutes gone in this bout. As Sipsa crashes on Rick DeBoe. Again, one, two, but not three again. And Sipsa, though in charge, is having a little trouble rolling him up. And right here, he might do it, two. Not quite three again. That was close.
This Simpson is relentless. He just keeps coming at you.
He does indeed. He works it hard. And a reverse shoulder pin. But I don't. One, two, and three did it this time. Steve Simpson rolls up a victory here over Rick DeBoe. So let's go down to Mark Lorenz.
5 minutes, 28 seconds. Steve Simpson, your winner.
And Steve runs off for the victory, and we want to thank Gary Holder for dropping by with those outstanding words of encouragement and excitement. And we're good to see you.
Well, it's always good to be here.
And we'll be back with a bit of information from Lance Von Erich next on World Class Championship Wrestling. Who has the main event against Nord the Barbarian, which seems to be appropriate since that incident that occurred about a week ago.
How you doing, Bill? Good to see you.
How you feeling about this?
Let me tell you something. I came out here last week, as you know, and I was being nice and polite. I came out here, and I was waiting for my time to do my interview. And as I turned around, of course, there was Gary Hart and Nord the Barbarian. As I turned around, of course, Gary Hart wouldn't give me time on the interview, so I made my way back. And I waited. I was being a gentleman. Came back up here, still couldn't get time to talk. Turned around and Nord the Barbarian attacked me. He's a big man. He is a big man. But let me tell you something. The Barbarian may be big and he may be strong, but inside, he's not a big man. He jumped me from behind. It doesn't take a big man to jump someone from behind, does it?
It really doesn't, Ed. That was totally uncalled for. You know, Gary Hart is building up a stable of large and undesirable kind of guys.
Yeah, it's true. And I tell you, anybody that goes with Gary Hart is selling their soul to the devil. I turned around, of course, and he jumped on me. Well, let me tell you something. He didn't expect me to jump on top of him, and I took him down to the floor, as you saw. It took three referees to take me, to pull me away. Let me tell you something. We started something, and we hadn't finished it. Nor the Barbarian, it's going to be you and me, and we're going to the limit.
And you're
going to
finish it on the main event?
You bet.
All right, thank you, Lance.
Oh, yeah,
Bobby Fulton, what are you guys doing here?
Well, I'll tell you.
I'm the World Tag Team Champion. Yes,
well, it's a proud moment for the Fantastics. Thank you very much to be out here on World Class Television.
And sound I sound like an auctioneer.
I do sound like an auctioneer because I'm so excited about being here. You know, the Fantastics are the original party animals, and we love to come here and be amongst all these great fans, party animals.
Oh, I see. Okay.
You know where our party is happening?
Like you're the original sharp-dressed man.
Yes. Where there's a party happening, the Fantastics are there. I want to tell you, a lot of tag teams here are tough. You know, Madrid, Adidas, they are coming back for rematches. Also, we got the Rock and Roll RPMs. A lot of things are happening. As long as you fans, I mean our friends, stand behind us, the Fantastics plan on keeping these belts a long, long time.
That's right. You know, Mr. Mercer, Bobby and myself, we jumped in with both feet right here in the world-class area, and we said we made a pact between each other that we was going to get these world-class tag team belts, and that's exactly what we did with help with all of our friends. And we'd just like to thank everybody out there because we know you're behind us. And just like Bobby said earlier, Al Madrill, Brian Adidas, there's a lot of tag teams here. There's the Rock and Roll RPMs, but we know Al Madrill and Brian Adidas are going to be the first ones in line because they have to defend your belt in 30 days. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to go by the rules and regulations, and after Al Madrill and Brian Adidas, well, the list goes on and on because you got the Rock and Roll RPMs, you got Dingo Warrior, you got the Red River Jack combination. There's a lot of combinations here in the world class area, and we're just looking forward to stepping in the ring, and with all the people's support, we're going to walk out with these world class tag team belts. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you. Hey. All right, the Fantastic Bobby Fulton, Tommy Rogers. Well, on World Class Championship Wrestling, in the ring is Hank Wilburn, and entering the arena in a very special sort of way is Eli the Eliminator. And here he comes, and on his famed Harley Davidson. Well, not since Black Bart came in on his horse. And this is a little different approach as Eli the Eliminator. Jim Holliday riding on his back seat. Jim Holliday, the sports agent of H&H International with Gary Hart. So there's the Harley. And there's Eli. Be a little easier to ride it in than push it out. So Eli the Eliminator is coming in. And let's go down to Mark Lawrence now and this bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout. One fall with a 30-minute time limit. Would you welcome, please, the man entering the building on the Harley Davidson, 295 pounds, Eli the Eliminator. In his corner, gentleman Jim Holliday, managing from H&H International. And behind me, would you welcome from Montreal, Quebec, 240 pounds, handsome Henry Wilburn. Rick Hazard, your referee.
Handsome Henry Wilburn or Hank Wilburn, whichever one you prefer. He prefers Handsome Henry. Eli the Eliminator, who prefers to keep his chaps on, and he is going to work with leather and fists and gloves and the whole bit as Jim Holliday. Gentleman Jim Holliday watches the sports agent, and the Eliminator, one, two, but he pulls him up. Eli is one of those guys that likes to take charge and then punish a man. And Henry Wilburn hasn't laid a glove on him yet. But Eli has laid gloves, leather, vest, and his whole entourage across the chest and back of Henry Wilburn. So Eli.
Come on, Pugh.
Making a dramatic entrance on his Harley Davidson with Jim Holliday on the back. So he brought his agent in style, and he's trying to put Henry Wilburn down in style. Henry gets up. Henry goes down. Henry's up. And Eli puts him into the corner buckle.
Watch that thing go.
That's up.
Watch that, Von Erich.
Holiday yelling, watch out, Dingo, watch out, Von Erich.
Come on, baby.
Come on. Well, we look, looking at Eli the Eliminator reminds me of Black Bart. Whoa. Woo! We may not remember Wilburn very long if that keeps going on. But Black Bart and Scott Casey are signed to have their drugstore cowboy match. The loser.
Yeah.
Has to put a saddle on his back and let the winner ride him around the ring. One, two, and he pulls him up again. Eli the Eliminator having fun right now with Henry Wilburn, who hasn't had any fun at all in this bout. Jim Holliday, the agent of H&H International, Hart and Holliday.
Pretty work, champ. Champ working on the chump.
Eli the Eliminator.
Watch the count, Eli. Watch the count, baby.
Jim Holliday keeping a constant bit of chatter. Here's a neck breaker. Oh, well executed by Eli. Holliday has not laid a bare fist on Eli yet.
Where's Hank going to go?
And he's going to let my head drop. Oh. And that might finish him for good. One. Two, and this time three, and Eli Eliminator eliminates Henry Wilburn. There he is, tattooed, leathered, Harley Davidson, and sunglasses. He didn't wear those. Let's go down to Mark Lawrence.
In exactly 2.5 minutes, Eli the Eliminator wins.
2.5 minutes of agony for Henry Wilburn, but not for the Eliminator.
Hope you've enjoyed all of the great matches the last few Legends programs, especially today. Time to check out some of the highlights of our next program. Handsome Hank will be with us for the first time. Hank, the Fantastics, Bruiser Brody, and a whole lot more in the next edition of the Legends of World Class Championship Wrestling. For today, until next time, I'm Mark Durant. Thanks for being with us. So long, everyone.